What's up everyone, it's Wesley from Central. Today I'm gonna show you another perfect war that we had against Beta M Unlimited. We actually got the war within 8 hours. So, they actually gave up attacking quite early. We're gonna start at the bottom with some Town Hall 8. It's been a while since we shared those. So, it's awesome going in. Old time member came back. He just lost our clan, so, but who doesn't? So, he's coming with a weird strategy here, actually. Quite a lot of different troops being used. So let's just see how he does it. Wizard at the bottom to clear some buildings out of the way of everything else. Golem to tank. And another golem on the top with the CC being out, poison down, and wizards to kill off the king. Excuse me, the dragon. Some more wall breakers coming down. And at this point, the kill squad will go in. Another max pack out from the clan castle. And they seem to be going just to head to base. He did bring two heals and one rage. Some more wall breaks to get even further in. This is actually quite a lot of value from a kill squad. Then come the hugs from the top. Just dripping in on some different buildings. And with two heal spells left. At this point, that means the base is already history, because one bomb is being popped by one hawk, and still five hawks left coming from the bottom with a heal spell on them. Actually misplaced heal spell, but it still did the job. And there come the rest of the hawks to get the last couple of defenses, and another heal spell can get them throughout the rest of the base. So nice attack, a combination that you don't see a lot. I've never seen it myself, to be honest. But he did get the freestyle, and that's what matters. So, nice job by Awesome. He actually brought a six pack. The other one was against a new Town Hall 9. So. And we're gonna go to number 11. Excuse me, 10. Minion going in with the HGHB attack. He's coming in from the bottom with the giants and the healers behind it. This way he will kill off the wizard tower and the bomb tower right away, saving possibly another heal for the hawks later. So, wizards to create a funnel, and as soon as the funnel is created, the heroes and the bowlers can come down, going inwards. Nice path leading to the middle towards the enemy heroes. The giants will be going through the wall as soon as the Tesla pops up there. Poison down on CC, and the rage spell to get them through it faster. And the sides is cleared in such a way that they have no other place to go than to the middle. So going in there nicely, King bursts through another wall, and another rage spell coming down to do some more damage there, to save at least one of the healers. The middle is destroyed at this point, so the hawks are coming in from one side, probably using a heal there already. There we go, a little misplaced, but still does a job. Archer tower will be turned back to. But the other defense on north are already distracted, so the hawks can go without possibly using a heal spell already. Even though some of the spring traps did get some of the hawks. Another heal spell left, and with only three defenses left. And still quite a few hawks, and possibly a bomb there in the middle. But should be more than enough to get through the base, especially if the giant's still alive. And the queen just popped her ability too. So there we go, nice raid by my minion, another free star in the back. Even saves his poison spell, there's only one needed. Then we go to number 7, Sam going in. Similar sort of base, but he's using the GoHo strategy. This base is a new Town Hall 10, which dropped his third expo already. Other than that, his heroes were not even maxed, so don't ask me why he went to Town Hall 11 already. But Golem's going in with some wizards behind it, and the queen and the king jump to get them to the middle. No rage spell used in this attack, because the kill squad alone without the rage can do more than enough damage, and there are no bowlers in the CC which will benefit from that rage spell. Poison down for the CC, wizards to clear out already. And my hero's already down and the Hawks are already coming from the top with the first heal spell. Getting to the first compartment. Some of the skeletons are being poisoned because they can harass your Hawks pretty bad. Another heal spell to cover the Teslas and the second compartment. Some wallbreakers trying to distract some defenders, I guess. But last heal spell to cover that compartment, and then there's one compartment to go, including two wizard towers. So it might get a little bit sketchy in the end. But as long as not all the Hawks are being targeted at the same time and they avoid most of the giant bombs, that means the base is already over actually. All the bombs have already popped at this point. So there's so many Hawks left, that means this base is history. So nice attack by Sam. The rest is on a cleanup, so I'm just gonna close it off. And we go to number 2. Wartooth going in against a 10.5 with, well, pretty low heroes for a tunnel 11. But this is actually 10.5, meaning no eagle. But other than that, point defense is mostly upgraded as much as you can. So Queen Walk starting on the left and King on the right. To distract some of the defenders there and try to create a little bit of funnel. As soon as the queen takes out the gold storage, she will go in. Queen actually helps her that way. She actually does not go in. King pops her ability to get some more of the defenses, and then the queen turns around because the queen king ability was being popped. So more wall breakers down to try and go to the middle. But to reach both the infernos from there. The part is done. The dragon actually just killed off the king, so it will come back to the queen. But just probably a rage fell down. Oh, no ability even to get through the dragon. And then as soon long as she managed to kill off the warden there, yeah. There's only a multi-target inferno and an expo hitting her, so she won't really live now. Airbrushing coming in with 3 lava hounds on 2 of the air defenses and a shitload of balloons. And all kind of haste to speed them through it. And at this point there's still like 3 haste and a rage to the left. Warden ability to try and go to the infernos. And the first inferno actually went down at this point. And the rage fell to get quicker to the other one. And that's also the last air defense down. So at this point there's only 2 defenses left, and that means the base is history. Not even all the hounds are being popped. Not even all have been popped, so. But this means the base is history, so I'm gonna fast forward. And then an attack on a max tunnel 11. One of our tunnel 10s actually already got, like, I need to check, 79% on the tunnel 11. So one of our tunnel 11s went in after that to finish it off using the go-ho strategy. Let's see how he does it. Coming from the left with the golems, wizards to start creating the funnel right away. Another golem at the bottom, and more wizards. And then you will open up the wall. All the wizard towers at the bottom, including the eagle, that means most of the AoE targeting defenses are at the bottom. So we'll save a lot of heal spells needed on his hawks later. The Prolus going in and a rage spell to get through it quicker. Warden ability to try and save some of the defenses. Golem alone even popped a bomb, so saves the Prolus there. And at this point, half of the base is already gone. The queen is still alive though, which is a little bit tricky with the Hawks. As soon as they come in, I mean, it's 4 heal spells, or 5 heal spells even, for the Hawks, so should hopefully be enough. The bowlers are still going and they will take out the expo over there. And the queen is still going strong to probably going around actually. There come the Hawks. First heal spell is being used on the heroes and the bowlers. Second heal spell is coming down on the Hawks on top. A nice Tesla farm coming up there. At least the queen is already busy on the Hawks. But there is just so many, and including in the heals and the, it's pretty low level queen actually. So with just 1 heal to go and 4 defenses all being able to be targeted by that one heal. That means the base is history. So a nice 3 star on the town hall 11 by Infinite. I believe it's his first one actually. Even though it wasn't a maxed out town hall 11, it's still a nice triple on the base with an eagle. So nicely done. And that was it. Another perfect war added to the record. So let's hope we can continue to do this, because there's a lot of town hall 11 triples going on at the moment. But yeah, thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and see you next time.